In order to replace the forces acting on the truss by a single force in a couple moment acting at point C, we can start by resolving the forces in its x and y component and then combining them together to figure out the resultant force. So to start, our 500 pound force is acting at an angle given by the right angle triangle. To calculate its x component, we can multiply the 500 with 4 over 5. This will give us the x component of the 500 force equals to 400 pound. Next, we can go ahead and add all the y components of the forces acting on the truss. In this case, starting with the 500 pound, if we multiply it with 3 over 5, it is going to give me the y component. In this case, it is pointing downward, so that's why we will take it as negative. Similarly, our 100 pound force, 150 pound force, and 200 pound force are all acting in the negative y direction. So adding them all together give us the resultant force in the y direction as negative 750. Here the negative sign is indicating it is acting downward. Now to calculate the resultant force magnitude, we can apply our formula of square root of x component squared plus y component squared. This is give us the final value of 850 pound. Now in order to identify the direction of the resultant force, we can use the tan inverse formula, that is taking a tangent inverse of the y component's magnitude divided by the x component magnitude, which gives us an angle of 61.9. Now to represent it at point C, since our x component is going towards the right and y component is going downward, it makes our force in the fourth quadrant, and the angle is measured in the clockwise direction from the positive x axis. Next, let's go ahead and figure out the resultant coupled moment at point C. That will be equals to the sum of moment of all the forces acting on the truss with respect to point C. So we can go ahead and start with our 200 pound force acting downward and have a moment arm of 2 feet. This force is going to create our clockwise moment as the moment arm is towards the left of the force. Similarly, 150 pound force and 100 pound force are going to create our clockwise moment. That's why they are taken as negative. Next, I have our 500 times 4 over 5 that is applied horizontally. So the moment arm is in the vertical direction of 6 feet. This force is going to create our clockwise moment as well. Finally, we have our 500 times 3 over 5 force that has a moment arm of 8 feet. Again, this is going to make our clockwise moment. So adding them all together, we get our final value of negative 6,400 pound feet. Here the negative sign is indicating that the moment is in clockwise direction.